Hello students, we are doing the classification of business activity. In the previous video we have completed with the classification of industries. Today we are going to do the classification of the another part, that is commerce. We are going to only revise the definition of industries. Industries includes all those activities which involves conversion of raw material into the finished goods. Coming to the another part, what do you mean by commerce? Commerce refers to buying and selling of goods and services, or we can say all those activities which involves buying or selling of goods and services comes under the category of commerce. Now we're going to do the classification of commerce. Now we're going to start with the classification of commerce. Now commerce is basically divided into two parts. First one is trade, another one is auxiliaries to trade. Coming to the first part of commerce, that is trade. Now, trade refers to all those activities which involves buying and selling of goods and services with the motive to earn profit. Okay, with the motive to earn profit, when we are dealing in buying and selling of goods and services, it is known as trade. Trade is of two kinds, internal and external. When trade takes place within the geographical boundaries of our country, then it is known as internal trade. When trade takes place between two or more different countries, then it is termed as external trade. Now, internal trade is again of two kinds, retail trade and wholesale trade. Retail trade is that trade in which goods are taken by retailers from the wholesalers and then it is sold to ultimate consumers. When we are talking about wholesalers, wholesalers are those particular sellers who produce the goods or who purchase the goods in bulk quantity from the owners or manufacturers and sell small quantities to that of the retailers. Coming to the external categories, external trade is of three kinds, export, import and intraport. When we are just selling the goods outside our country, it is known as export. When we are purchasing the goods from other countries, it is known as import. And when we are importing the goods with the purpose of again re-exporting it, it is known as intraport. So here we have completed with classification of trade. Giving a brief again a recap of this, trade is of two kinds, internal trade and external trade. Trade within the geographical boundaries will be considered as internal trade. Trade across the geographical boundaries is known as external trade. Internal trade, retail and wholesale trade. Retailers are those persons who purchase the goods from wholesalers and sell it to the consumers. Wholesalers are those persons who purchase the goods from the manufacturers and sell in small quantities to that of retailers. Export, when we are selling goods to the other countries. Import, when we are purchasing goods from other countries. And intraport, when we are importing goods for re-exporting it to the other countries, it is known as intraport. Coming to the next one, that is auxiliaries to trade. Now, all those activities which provide support to our trade are termed as auxiliaries to trade. Again, I am repeating, all those activities which actually provide support to trade is known as auxiliaries to trade, or we can say aids to trade. Now, these are various activities which are coming under the categories of auxiliaries to trade. First one is transportation. We know transportation is required to just move the raw material from the place of source to the place of factory and finished goods from the place of factory to the marketplace. Again, warehouses are needed to just store the goods, to protect the goods against the damage and to maintain the supply of goods in the market. Third one, communication is required in trade to provide timely information through that of producers, consumers, sellers. For all these things, communication is required. It includes our internet facilities, telephone facilities. This activity, that is banking. Banks are required for trade to provide various kinds of loan, say small term loan, medium term loan, or we can say long term loans. At the same time, bank also help us to just deposit our excess money into the bank, at the same time clearing of checks, discounting of bills. These all things are being done by that of auxiliaries to trade under banking and finance. Coming to the next one, insurance. Insurance is also required by trade for covering various kinds of risk, say losses caused due to that of fire, theft, natural calamities. So for all these things, so for covering the risk, we require insurance. Coming to the next one, that is advertising. Advertising is required for trade in order to promote our product in the market, and moreover it is also being required to inform the consumers regarding the availability of goods and services in the market. So taking a quick recap of all these activities, we require transportation for just movement of raw materials to our factory place, at the same time movement of finished goods to the market place. We require warehousing for the storage of goods to protect them from damage and to maintain continuous supply of goods in the market. We require communication to timely pass the information from producers to manufacturers to wholesalers to retailers. We require banking to obtain loans, to just deposit our excess money, to just clear the checks, to just open our discounting of bills, other schemes. Insurance is required to cover various kinds of risks such as loss due to theft, fire, etc. Advertising is required to promote our product and to inform the consumers regarding the availability of goods in the market. That's all for today. Hope you understood the whole classification of commerce. Thank you.